Good job. Let's give all the kids another big hand, all right? Thank you, guys. I tell you, that is awesome this morning. Appreciate them. Appreciate Kathy and Christy and Dana and Haley and Cynthia. Who am I leaving out on Sunday school? All them teach Sunday school. Children's church, they average 20, 25 back there, 15 to 30 sometimes. It varies, but appreciate all that they do with their children. And you guys are going to stay out here with us this morning, all right? And they want to go sit with mom and dad. That would probably be a good thing, all right? But we're not going to be long this morning. I just want to say thank you, mom. I want to say thank you, children. Turn to Luke 18 with me. And we just want to look at some verses in the Bible where God's kind of talking about children. You know, if I had to ask mom what the most important thing is in her life, it would be her kids. And I just wanted to thank you, moms, for being here today. You being here tells me that you care about what God has for your kids. And I appreciate that so very, very much. Appreciate you older ones now that have come to church with mom today. It's good to have my mom here with me today. And moms are special for sure. But I was looking at just a few verses, and I knew the kids wouldn't. The attention span is about like some of us older ones sometime, you know. But I wanted to talk about just a few things this morning, and I wanted to talk about showing the way. I see moms and dads that take time with their kids and they pray with them. Those are huge times. Those are huge moments in those kids' lives that they will always remember. And sometimes I know we're busy and we're tired, and I just as a pastor, I struggle sometimes. Dad, will you come pray with us? All right, let's go back. You know, when they're asking you to pray with them, that is huge. And so I appreciate that so much. Appreciate all of you that have raised your kids in that way. And it kind of goes into what we talked about at the beginning of our service today. Life is so uncertain. Life is so unsure. And while we have them in our home, we just pour as much of the Lord into them as we can. And we know that when they get older, they're going to make their own decisions. But what my prayer is and what your prayer is that we have told them enough about the Lord that when it comes to those tough decisions in life, they will hearken back. They will look back to that time and say, you know, I remember Dad, or I remember Mom, or I remember praying, or I remember reading that scripture that said, I need not do, as I said a while ago, God's top 10 is what he was trying to say for you. God's top 10. And they were looking at those things and learning those things, maybe in a different language than what we did, but still at the heart of the matter there. So just so important as we look at that. I wanted to look at this first time here that's probably very familiar to a lot of us when the ladies, probably moms, if you read some of the different gospels, in different gospels they kind of say it in a different way, but they were talking about the mothers bringing their children to Christ. And, you know, at this time, I know they were just bringing them to him for healing a lot of times from physical ailments, but also they knew that there was something special about Jesus. And so, read this verse with me here in Luke 18. People were also bringing babies to Jesus for him to place his hands on them. And just the touch of God and the tenderness of God. And there's a lot to be said for a hug or a pat on the back or a positive word in your kids' lives. And, Mama, you're probably the best at that there is. I don't think, you know, a lot of us know in our minds that we probably could never do nothing wrong in the sight of our mom. And we thank you, moms, for being such encouragers and such ones that come to us when maybe everybody else is mad at us. Mom says, she might say, I'm not real happy, but I still love you, and here's what we got to do to get through that. And dads, I'm not leaving you out today. It's just mom's special day, but you can do the same things too. It says, when the disciples saw this, they rebuked them. You know, Jesus was tired. He's constantly moving, constantly teaching. He's trying to push all that into 3.5 years we've been talking about in Matthew. And they seen that Jesus was tired, but Jesus always has time for someone else, doesn't he? Isn't that amazing? You might think, man, God is so busy, he don't have time for my little prayers. God is so busy, he don't have time to worry over my children. But guys, he is watching, and he cares. And don't ever forget that. But he says, when they saw, they rebuked him, but Jesus called the children to him. You can just kind of see this picture. He might have been sitting on a stump or sitting on a hillside or on a rock. You just never know, but you can just see Jesus said, y'all come over here, come here, you know, and those kids running to Jesus just for that hug or that kind word. And some were healed. Some were healed physically. But just the spirit of that. It says, but Jesus called the children to him and said, let the little children come to me and do not hinder them. Guys, that's one you need to underline there, okay? Here at that moment, they're saying, you know, don't keep them back from me. But guys, I think that we all have to look in the mirror and say, am I doing anything in my life that may cause my children to be hindered to finding Christ? And guys, that's a big question. That's a big question. I may not be the smartest in helping them with their algebra or their math or their English, but I tell you, I can learn how to tell them about Jesus. And I do not want anything in my life. You know, they're watching you. Man, I have noticed that. You can see my girls are growing quickly, but they watch everything you do. They listen to everything you do. And so if you want somebody to know something, especially Pop-Pop, you better make sure that that's what you want Pop-Pop to know, because he's going to find out about it, all right? He told me not too long ago, he said, you had a wreck in your truck, didn't you? I said, yeah, how'd you find that out? He said, and he told me, you know. But I had bumped into somebody. Wasn't a big deal. I wasn't going to make a big deal out of it. But Annie said, yep, Dad had a wreck just the other day, you know. So you got to be careful. They're watching you. And so, guys, what I'm getting at is we want to make sure that we don't hinder them in coming to Jesus. Now, in this verse here, they're talking about them physically coming to him. But make sure that we are showing the Lord. Make sure we are praying in front of them, taking that extra minute or so to pray over our dinner. Take an extra minute to pray with them at bedtime, reading the scripture to them, bringing them to church, all right? Guys, I'm going to tell you, I'm old-fashioned. I think we ought to, you know, till they get out of the house, if we're going to church, we're all going to church, all right? That's kind of old-fashioned these days, but I believe you need to bring your kids to church, because let them pick between video games and church, they're going to pick video games, all right? They just like playing, and I don't blame them, they like playing. But guys, we have got to be the leader in their life and not hinder them from finding Jesus. And so they will find him. And I've found out that if you find him at an early age, it's a lot better off than if you wait till you're 30 and 40 and 50 or 60 years old. And so it's very important as we look at that. Do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Man, what a statement. For the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Truly I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it, will never enter it. Think about that just for a minute. How do kids love you as a parent when they're small? They love you unconditionally. They trust you. If you tell them you're going to take them somewhere, I guarantee you they're going to tell you about 25 times, hey, we're going there on Friday. We've had to learn to not tell them until the day before, because they will drive you crazy, Angie, until you take them, you know? If we tell them on Monday, is it time yet? Are we going today? No, Friday, okay, next day. Are we going today? It's today, isn't it? No, Friday, all right? So you've got to realize they're going to be asking, they're going to be wanting to know, and they want they want to be who they are. They trust you to say what you're saying that you're going to do. And guys, you think about it, that's the way we come to Jesus. We love him unconditionally. We trust him to do exactly what he's going to say. And it's just amazing as you think about that. And also, it says, don't try to make ourselves worthy. You know, a kid comes to you and say, Dad, I'd like to have $5 for whatever, all right? A spinner thing, all right? That's the big thing right now. See right here, all right? All right? And you're sitting there spinning that thing, and Gary, we could have been rich making them things, you know? But, you know, they're not going to say, I know I'm not worthy, but I need $5. They're just going to come to you straight up and say, I need some money, all right? And when they get older, it doesn't stop. It just, now I need a car, okay? And I've just graduated, Mom. You know, can you fix me up, all right? So that's coming, all right? But listen to me. They don't have to come to you and say, I'm not worthy, but... And when we go to Christ, yes, we know that we're not worthy, but they don't sit there and run themselves down saying, well, I'm so terrible and I'm so awful that there's no way that God would save me. Because what has God said? He said, he's not willing that any should perish. He's willing that everyone should find the Lord. And guys, yes, we know that we're not worthy of his salvation, but when we go to him and we say, Lord, will you save me? And we trust him to do that, you know what he's going to do? He's going to save you. He's going to save you. And so there's so many people not took that last step of salvation because they say, I'm not worthy, and I've done this in my past, and I've had this in my history, and this and that. And guys, none of us are proud of our past. We have things in our past that we are not proud of. But you know what? Christ forgives that. Christ died on the cross for that. And so what he's saying, look, you can't come into my kingdom unless you come as a little child. Don't sit there and run yourself down to the point that you don't accept me. Just come to me and ask. Come to me and ask what you want. Ask me for salvation. And Jesus says, I'll save you. I'll save you. And then others are on the other side of that. They pretend they don't need it. There's very seldom that I hear my kids pretend, oh, I know I don't want that, Dad. I really don't need that, you know. Yes, they want it. And so we don't have to pretend like we don't need it. Yes, we do need Jesus. Yes, we can't take another breath without him. The kids know that if you're not there, it's going to be difficult for them to be able to live like they want to. They know they need you every moment of the day. And we should need Jesus just like that, the very same way, very same way. Let's look at another scripture. And this was where, you know, the disciples were always trying to figure out who was number one on the totem pole. You know, it's kind of like, Mama, which one of us do you love the most? If I had to ask Miss Mildred this morning which one of them kids she loved the most, she would probably tell me, or I know she would tell me, I love them all the same, wouldn't you? I love them all the same. My mama's told me that. You know, my brothers and sisters don't believe it because I am the favorite child, but they don't believe that, but they love them all the same, okay? They love them all the same. Now, the disciples were always like that. Lord, which one of us is the best? Which one of us, when we get to heaven, are you going to say, this is my disciple, he was the very best? And the Lord just kind of goes a 180 from him, all right? Look what he says. At that time, disciples came to Jesus and asked, who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And maybe not even themselves, but who out there is going to be the greatest? Here's what Jesus does and says. He called a little child to him. Cardi, come here. He brought this young man right out of the crowd. He said, right here, it's going to be the greatest. These that trust me. These that I don't have to keep proving myself to them over and over and over. Those that know that I'm going to deliver every time they ask. It's not going to be about how much you know or how much Bible you've memorized. It's how pure your heart is when you get to the kingdom of heaven. Thank you, buddy. Give him a good hand, all right? He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. He said, truly I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you know, we will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever takes the lowly position of this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. Guys, listen, I know sometimes they get a little noisy. I know sometimes they come up to that mic and go, God's top 10, all right? But you know what? Crystal, we love them to death. You know what? We love them. And guys, I'm telling you, there's churches across our country today would just love the noise of children. And God has blessed us with that. And sometimes they will drive you up a wall, all right? I got three that does that, all right? But I'm telling you, the Lord says, you better receive them. You better love them. You better hold on to them. Because if you don't receive them, there's no way you'll be received in heaven. That's a pretty big deal right there, you know? That's a big deal. What did it say going to time 5? And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. And when these children are welcome, and they're going to put some spots on the floor, and they're going to mark on the wall from time to time, and Brother Todd's one of them neat freaks, and that, I can clean that up. But then God slaps me upside the head and says, remember how precious those children are in his sight. And what a big deal Bible school is, and what a big deal Sunday school is, and what a big deal children's church is, and what a big deal this ministry of Stepping Stones is over here to reach out to families and children that mom and dad is working, and those ladies are in there working hard every day to love on those kids and take care of those kids. Guys, that's a big ministry that God has given us in this church, 4, 5, 6-fold, GPS. Sunday nights we have stuff with the kids. Sunday mornings, it goes on and on and on, guys. And mamas, we thank you for loving your kids. We thank you for bringing them here where we can love them with you. And church, may we always just thank the Lord every time we see a child and say, Lord, thank you for letting him feel welcome in this place and help us to receive that child. Amen? Amen. May we always do that. One more, and then we're going to go eat lunch with Mama. I thought this verse jumped out to me this week, and I don't know if I've ever seen it this way. Matthew 18:10 says, "See that you do not despise one of these little ones." It kind of goes along with what we're talking about. But look at this way this verse reads here. "For I tell you that their angels in heaven always see the face of my Father in heaven." I don't know if I've ever seen that or read that way before. Listen, one more time. "For I tell you that their angels..." Isn't it amazing that every child in here this morning has an angel? You might call that a guardian angel. You know, we kind of get a little bit, "Oh, I don't know," you know. But I think if you look right before the scripture, it's talking about don't keep anyone from coming to Christ. And listen, if you're a newborn Christian, no matter what age you are, you're a child in Christ. He said, don't be a stumbling block. He said, it'd be better if they put a stone around your neck and threw you in the water than to keep someone from coming to Christ. Guys, every one of us that know Christ has that guardian angel. Isn't that amazing to think about? You think about these little children, and they have their angel. And he said, look, if you're going to be mean to them, if you're going to despise them, and then step that up a notch, not only the children in physical years, but these young ones in Christ. Because what I've noticed, guys, a lot of times, that old devil, when somebody comes and gives their heart to Christ at 30 or 40 or 25 or 50, it seems like those next 6 weeks, that devil just hammers on them every way he can, trying to keep them from being productive for Christ. And he blasts them and blasts them, and all of a sudden they just back up and said, "I didn't know it was going to be this hard. And guys, we must be there to support and encourage not only these little ones physically that we've seen today on this stage, but also these babes in Christ, these people that are not grown up in Christ yet. And listen, if truth be known, none of us are very old in Christ, because there's so much more to learn, so much more to do, and so much more things to see. But when you think about God has a special angel looking over every one of these that are his and over us that are his, guys, that's an honor. But also that takes it where we have to look at ourselves and say, are we treating people the way that we should treat them? Are we living in such a way that we might cause someone to stumble and not find Christ, or someone to not be productive for Christ? And guys, we have to look at ourselves in the mirror every day, and we have to take responsibility that we live for Jesus, not only for each other, but also for these little ones that are watching us. And you might think, well, they don't ever watch me. They don't even know who I am. They know. These kids know more than we'll ever imagine they know. And they need to know Jesus. They need to know you love them. And we just need to continue to love on them. I thought that was amazing to know. Sometimes I worry about my girls, man. That oldest one, you know, she's getting there where pretty soon she's already hitting me up for a driver's license this summer, Gary. And man, I spent hours in prayer over that, and trying to find somebody's car to borrow so we could learn how to drive, all right? You know, they're growing up, guys, and they're getting big, and they're going to be out of our house soon. A lot of you already experienced all this, all right? A lot of you now are looking at grandchildren and worrying over them, and great-grandchildren and worrying over them. But guys, may we always realize how important it is that they know and that we show them the way to Jesus Christ. Amen? Man, how important it is. I want to end this morning with the mother's prayer. Next screen here. And I can just kind of hear all the moms in this crowd praying this today. You can kind of read along with me as I read it. Lord, give me strength just for today to lead my children in your way. Oh, give me wisdom, Lord, and grace to show to them your precious face. And help me, Lord, to teach them, too, the things of Christ so rich and true. Just let them see in me, dear Lord, your holiness in life and word. Keep me from sinning with my tongue, from harsh, quick words that might have stung their tender hearts that trust me so, and watch to see which way I go. Dear Father, keep my thoughts so pure that they will always know for sure. My Lord has led me all the way. Lord, grant my prayer just for today. And you know what? Then tomorrow we get up and we pray that again. We just take step by step, day by day. Not only moms, but dads. Not only moms and dads, but grandmas and grandpas. Aunts and uncles can be huge in the lives of these kids. And guys, may we always reach out to live in such a way that these kids can find their way, and we would never hinder them from Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you all today. Let's go, Lord, in prayer, okay? Dear Father, we thank you so much today for these moms. We thank you for their love for us. Lord, for their children. Maybe some have already grown up. And Lord, we thank you for those that are still raising children. Lord, we ask you to be with each one of those moms. We thank you for the role that grandmas have played in raising children through the years. Many of us probably are sitting here today knowing you as Savior because grandma shared the good word with us. And Lord, I just pray that as a church, as a pastor, as leaders, as Sunday school teachers, as people that come week after week, people that are members of this church, Lord, may we always remember the great task that we've been assigned. Lord, the great responsibility that we have to show these children you, and Lord, not to hinder them. Lord, may we remember also in our heart that we must become like a little child. Lord, not to always doubt things, not to always wonder where the angle is, but Lord, to trust you, to love you unconditionally, and Lord, to know that when we ask you to forgive us, you're going to do that. Lord, our faith must be strong in you. Lord, sometimes we can't see things. And Lord, there's a lot of times my girls can't see what I'm going to do for them. But Lord, they trust me to do the right thing. And so, Lord, I know I can't see your hands. I didn't see you die on the cross. But Lord, I believe with all of my heart, just as sure as the nose on my face today, that Lord, you love me, that you love this great congregation today. You love people across this world. And Lord, you want everyone to come to you as a little child and ask for forgiveness. And Lord, you'll grant that. And I believe that with all my heart, Lord. Lord, just be with the moms today as they celebrate with their families, as they love on their kids, as they remember those maybe that have passed on. And Lord, that's always difficult. And Lord, we remember the moms that are not with us today. And I ask you to be there for those families a little bit extra today as they think about moms passed on. Lord, thank you for taking care of our moms. And Lord, if it's possible, would you tell them today that we love them and that we miss them. And we'll be home soon. Thank you, Lord, for your marvelous grace. Thank you for these children. And Lord, we go in your name today. May we all be blessed. In Jesus' name we pray.
Hey, thanks for joining us today. If you have prayer requests, need to contact us, or need directions to the church, check us out online at fbckaiser.com. If you want to join us, we're located at 210 East Main Street, or give us a call at 870-526-2604, or send mail to P.O. Box 306, Kaiser, Arkansas, 72351. We'd love to see you soon. Thanks again for joining us, and may God bless you.